The white abalone that are left in the wild are so far apart from one another that they can't reproduce successfully. And so we need to breed abalone in captivity and put them back out in the wild so they're close enough together that they can start reproducing on their own. We probably need tens to hundreds of thousands of animals to outplant every year to save this species. We are here in Long Beach to spawn some of our very precious white abalone here. Hopefully they will give us lots of new baby white abalone for our captive breeding program. We put them in this chemical solution, a little love potion, to get them to spawn. So this is the time when I start to get a little bit apprehensive. Oftentimes, if we're gonna have a really great spawning attempt, at least one or two animals will have gone off in the chemicals, and we haven't seen that yet today.
I don't think this one's into it.
This is certainly a bit disappointing that it hasn't happened here today, but it doesn't detract at all from the fact that we had a banner year. Earlier this year, we had the most successful spawning attempt we've had in the history of the program that resulted in tens of thousands of juvenile abalone. We're working really closely with Dr. Daniel Sweezy here at UC Davis Bodega Marine Lab and with the abalone farms to try to help prepare these animals better for the changing climate that they'll be facing in the wild.
So what we're finding is that the ocean is becoming more acidic and that this change is linked with climate change. And we're finding that that is impacting a lot of shellfish, that it's making it harder for them to grow. And specifically with abalone, we're seeing that a lot more of them die when they're little. But at the same time, there's kind of rays of hope. Some of them seem more resilient. So that's what our work is focused on, is finding those resilient individuals and figuring out if we can grow those abalone as the abalone of the future.
I'm invested both professionally and personally in this. My husband's family has been abalone diving for generations. We met diving, looking for abalone. My engagement ring, which I still wear years after marriage, is an abalone pearl. And we can't wait to teach our daughter one day to dive for abalone. This world is changing so quickly. My hope is that through some of this work, we can slow that change down a little bit. I really hope that abalone is something that our daughter sees as part of her present and part of her life, and not just something that her parents and grandparents enjoyed.